Hey guys, John V here from PhoneArena. Right now you're watching our video comparison between the 2013 edition of the Google Nexus 7 and the Apple iPad Mini. Now, the iPad Mini was introduced last fall in response to the original Nexus 7, so Apple came out with a smaller version of its flagship iPad device, and that's what you get with the iPad Mini. Now, 1 year later, we have the Nexus 7, a 2013 edition, and it's sporting a higher resolution screen and updated specs, of course. So it's gonna be interesting how these two top-notch flagship tablets are gonna fare against one another. Different price points, different experiences. Let's find out how they stack up. So there are many things we like about the respective designs. With the iPad Mini, it definitely has a premium taste with its construction, thanks primarily to its brushed aluminum casing. It adds a lot of sturdiness, a lot more than the Nexus 7, and it's also, on paper, the thinner tablet between the two. But that's where it pretty much ends, just because the Nexus 7 comes off as being the more comfortable tablet to hold in the hand, just because it's not as wide as the iPad Mini. At the same time, its construction is also decent, and we definitely like the soft touch feel of the back cover. It gives it a very clean approach and definitely has an appealing design of its own too. There's no arguing about this one. There's no question that the Nexus 7 has the superior display just because it has a higher resolution screen. So you have a larger 7.9-inch display on the iPad Mini versus the smaller 7-inch one in the Nexus 7. They're both IPS LCD panels at heart, so they have the same level of colors, nice natural color reproduction, wide viewing angles. But we give the Nexus 7 a slight advantage to the brightness output. It's just a little bit brighter, but both are still more than visible outdoors. But the most dramatic difference here is just in resolution. It's 1920 by 1200 on the Nexus 7 versus 1024 by 768 on the iPad Mini. And the pixel density is, there's just a huge difference with pixel density. 323 pixels per inch versus 162 pixels per inch on the iPad Mini. And you really notice that in the web browsers. We look at something from a zoomed out view, there's just more clarity and sharpness to the Nexus 7. Whereas with the iPad Mini, you see a little bit more graininess to it. In standard fashion, the iPad Mini features that iconic and tactile home button, whereas with the Nexus 7, there are no capacitive buttons with it. Instead, they're all incorporated into the interface. Meanwhile, above their displays, we find their front-facing cameras. They're both actually 1.2 megapixels in size, and they also feature their light sensors. With the Nexus 7, though, we really appreciate that it also features an LED notification light below the display. We really can't complain about their physical buttons, the power button and volume controls, just because they're very distinct, raised, and they're very springy as well. When it comes to charging data connectivity, they have different ports. It's a more favorable micro USB port on the Nexus 7, and of course, the iPad Mini utilizes the newer Lightning docking port. They might not be some of the first things we use when it comes to taking photos or videos, but it's nice to see that these two are outfitted with rear cameras. They're both 5 megapixels in size and both can shoot HD video. Interestingly enough, these two tablets feature dual speakers. With the iPad Mini, they're placed on the bottom edge. It just seems more logical the way the Nexus 7 has it, just because you have it both on the left and right edges. Naturally, the platform experience between the two differ greatly. With the iPad Mini and iOS, it's more focused about being simple and easy, and that's what you see with the layout of the UI, with the grid-like icons. It has a very nice way of dealing with notifications and even multitasking, so it works there. On top of that, you still have also Siri, so you could have some voice-guided search assistant if you need that. But it still just lacks the depth of personalization and functionality that Android 4.3 Jelly Bean on the Nexus 7 delivers. And with this latest version of Android, you get some nice new additions. For example, you have restricted profiles, which is great just because if you're using the tablet at home and the family is using it, so you have your kids, your wife, your spouse, stuff like that, it's great that you could monitor and actually restrict certain profiles from accessing certain applications. So that's very nice. You still don't have that with iOS and the iPad Mini. And on top of that, you just have a greater level of personalization with Android, with all the widgets, the background wallpapers, and does a fantastic job when it comes to notifications, multitasking, the whole works. But between the two, we still would say that the iPad Mini and iOS still has the more polished looking applications. taking a look at their core organizer apps, they pretty much have the same base functions and presentation, very ideal for the tablet form factor. But when we go further down, when we look at Siri versus Google Now, there's no arguing that Google Now has a superior edge to what it offers. Not only does it allow you to make appointments and look up contacts, but it even gives you other relevant details such as the weather, sports information, stocks, and even driving directions. Honestly, we don't find one keyboard to be better than the other just because they have the same level of responsiveness and they're also very spacious. On top of that, our fingers, our thumbs are able to encompass their layouts in portraits, so that's not a problem. With their landscape options, they're a little bit cramped, so we'd probably stick closer to the iPad mini for that one. Likewise, the two tablets work when it comes to surfing the web with the respective browsers. It's Chrome on the Nexus 7 and Mobile Safari on the iPad mini. They're able to load up complex web pages in the same fast pace. And top of that, they both have almost the same level of responsiveness, but we noticed just a little bit more fluidity going on with the Nexus 7. And of course, seeing that it has the higher resolution, it just makes for the more pleasing visuals between the two. Some people would probably give the slight edge to the Nexus 7 on paper just because it's packing a quad-core processor instead of the dual-core one in the iPad mini. To be exact, it's a quad-core 1.5 GHz Qualcomm Snapdragon S4 Pro processor with 2 GB of RAM in the Nexus 7 versus the dual-core 1 GHz Apple A5 processor with 512 MB of RAM on the iPad mini. So there's actually no difference between the performances. They're both very fast and swift and executing the same simple tasks. They're both to pretty much give us the same effective rate. So very quick, very few instances of slowdown or lag, and overall, they're pretty much on the same level to one another. Visually, their respective music players pretty much had the same presentation and functionality that we find on pretty much any other tablet out there. It doesn't really go above and beyond over other things. When it comes to their audio quality from their speakers, we gotta say they're both very strong, pretty much on the same level to one another at the highest volume setting. But just because the Nexus 7 has its speakers on the left and right sides, you get more of that stereo effect with it. If you just want to sit back and relax and watch movies on these tablets, they're both more than ideal for the occasion just because they're able to play high definition videos with minimal fluff. You could tell the playback is pretty smooth on both, but for some odd reason, we still probably go with the Nexus 7 just because of its higher resolution screen. You might not notice it as you're watching videos, but for other things, you might. And on top of that, there's just less conversion needed when transferring videos over to the Nexus 7 and also supports a wide array of codecs over the iPad mini. We wouldn't necessarily say that one tablet is better suited for taking photos just because they both have a very simple interface. They have touch focus enabled with both, very minimal when it comes to features or shooting modes. In fact, they're basically none on the iPad mini. You could modify the exposure on the Nexus 7. And on top of that, you also have other cool shooting modes such as panoramic and photospheres. In the camera and video recording quality department, we really can't proclaim a victor in terms of overall quality. The two are pretty good, especially for tablets, for shooting photos and videos. Both 5-megapixel cameras in the rear, both have autofocus, which is nice, and they have a good balance between details and color reproduction and also dynamic range. But when you take them indoors for still shots, their images tend to become noisier looking, so softer details in the end. And when it comes to video recording, like we said, both are fantastic with that, even for tablets, so you could still use them and not be ashamed of showing them off later. From our experience, we're able to get better battery life with the Nexus 7. In fact, it's able to pull up roughly 2.5 days of normal usage from a full charge, whereas with the iPad mini, still good, but it's lower at 1.5 days. At the end of the day, we can't help but think about pricing with these two tablets, and that's where the Nexus 7 has the supreme advantage. Starting off at $230 for the base 16 GB Wi-Fi model, it's absolutely more affordable than the iPad mini starting price point, which is $329 for the base 16 GB Wi-Fi model. At the same time, when it comes to the core experience, you're gonna get a better value out of the Nexus 7 just because you have things like multiple user support, restricted profiles, and just all the host of enhancements that Android has over the iOS experience on the iPad mini. The iPad mini still has that fantastic premium design, but that's pretty much what's going best for it right now. So if you want to learn more about either the tablets, guys, you could check out our website, phonearena.com. It's John V. Thanks for watching.